In this Python project series, we will be building a grocery store management system where we will be doing a three-tier application development, which means for the front end or the UI, we will use HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and Bootstrap. For the back end, we will use Python and Flask, and the database will be MySQL. So by working on this whole project and by building the system, you are getting a knowledge of how to build a complete software with all the layers, which is UI, backend, and database. At the end of this video series, you will have an exercise as well, so you can practice the concepts that you learned in my videos. Now, by working on these type of projects, you gain an understanding of how projects are executed in a corporate environment. So it is not just the technical skills. I will be covering some soft skills as well, such as how to manage your project, how to plan the project, how to build UI mockups, and so on. So overall, it will be a complete package to learn Python. So it's not just like you're watching Python videos, learning for loops and so on. You are building a complete application. And then you can maybe go to a nearby grocery store and you can ask them to build the application for their needs. So this project will be building only one or two screens, simple screens, but once you learn the whole thing end to end, you can build a more complicated system as well. So if you're not getting a job or something, you can do freelancing, you can approach nearby businesses, and you can just build the whole software for them. Any project that is centered around the front end or UI requires building UI mockups, and that's the first step in the project development. So for our project, what I did is took a note and pen and draw all different screens that I will need for this project. So the screen here will be maintaining the orders, and if you want to put a new order, you can click on that button, new order. In the grid, you will have list of orders with date, order ID, customer name, and so on. So just think about that. Let's say you are a grocery store owner and you have the system on your computer. You would like to see this screen as your homepage. And when someone comes to buy things, you will click on new order and you will start putting an order, right? So let's say that person bought some toothpaste, some hair oil, and so on. You start entering all those items in this different screen. You'll also have order ID, customer name, etc., and of course a total. And when you say save or submit an order, you know it will print an invoice and it will make an entry into a database. You can also have manage products screen where you are listing down all the products that is available in your grocery store. For example, in COVID era, many grocery store owners are now keeping a mask. So the mask wasn't there before. So now when mask or any new inventory, new product comes in, the person will click on that add new product button and add that. So these UI mockups gives you a clear understanding on what type of front end you want to build for your project. So if you are just thinking in your head that, oh, I'll do this and that, then it will not be very clear. Once you start building UI mockups as a business manager, many things will get clear to you. So in companies, big companies, often the business manager will gather the requirement and either he will prepare these mockups or he will take help of some UX or UI mockup designer to build these kind of screens. So as a business development manager, if you don't know the professional tools, you can maybe draw these mockups in a note and pen or a whiteboard, and then the UI mockup designer or UX designer. See, UX designer takes care of the flow, the color, look and feel. UI, there are companies where you have two different roles. There are other companies where you have only one role, which is the business manager will go with this rough idea to UX designer, and UX designer will build a beautiful mockups. So they can use simple software like Balsamiq. So in Balsamiq, you can build the mockups, which looks little better than your screenshots. not the screenshot, the handwritten drawing. Or you can use software like mockups.com, and these websites allow you to create a beautiful looking screens. So now, business manager and UX designer worked on creating these screens. They will go to engineering team now, and they will hand over these mockups along with the requirements. I have seen some engineering teams where the engineering team member also have this skills of building the mockups. Okay, so many times they can also do this. And once that is understood, the next step is engineering team will get together and think about the technical architecture. Now, some companies have software architect as a different role. So engineering team can go to software architect as well, or they can just decide on the architecture on their own. For our project, we'll build UI in HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and Bootstrap. The backend will be built in Python Flask Server. Database will be in MySQL. So this will be a three-tier application for us. There could be n-tier application where there are more than three layers involved, but these are like typical three layers involved in application like the one that we are building. Now, how do you make technology decision? How do you know if you want to use PHP or Python Flask? Well, it depends. It depends on what kind of skill set you have. Let's say if you have a team of 10 people, everyone knows PHP, but no one knows Python, then it's going to be hard to build it in Python. It also depends on the scalability, the situation. Sometimes maybe building it in PHP doesn't make sense, even if you have only PHP developer. Maybe you want to scale, and maybe you want to do numeric computing. Well, in that case, you better use Python. We are using MySQL as a database here because it is free and it is the most popular relational database. Okay. So based on various circumstances, you will make these technology decisions. And now that we have built our technical architecture, let's move on to prerequisite. So you need to know basic Python. So if you go to Code Basics, if you go to YouTube and search Code Basics Python, you'll find my tutorials. You need to just follow first 16 tutorials, right? 1-6, only till 16 tutorials, watch it. These are very easy, guys and girls. It requires you only 2 days to learn the 16 tutorials. So just do that. If you want to learn it in Hindi, I have Hindi tutorials as well. So learn first 16 tutorials. That way your Python fundamentals are clear. Then move on to this Khan Academy's HTML, CSS, JavaScript code. If you already know this technology, you don't have to, but you know, my guidance is for absolute beginner. So this course is pretty good. It gets your fundamentals clear on web development. So HTML, CSS, JavaScript is used in web and mobile application development, especially in front-end development, the UI. Then you need to know SQL basics, for which again another Khan Academy course. I have all the links of this courses in the video description below, so check it out. You need to also know a little bit of Bootstrap. Bootstrap is a big topic, so if you don't want to care, like worry about it too much, to skip it as I build this the different components in our application. I will give you knowledge on all this, so you will learn as you go. But if you have some time, you can refer to it, just get your understanding clear on this framework. So once you have prerequisites cleared, the next step would be to work on a database. So in the database, you will build a schema, you will create tables in MySQL. So that's what we'll cover in the next session.